Good morning, class 6. Your first chapter is about science and its importance. Since the beginning of civilization, human beings have been curious to know more about various natural phenomena, such as the formation of day and night, change of weather, occurrence of seasons, the variety of living organisms and their behavior, and the nature of substances around them. The constant efforts to understand the working of nature through centuries of careful observations and analysis has given birth to science and its various branches. The systematic study of the natural world through observations and experiments is known as science. Science is broadly divided into two main groups, physical sciences and life sciences or biology. These groups are further subdivided into different branches. Physical sciences include physics, that is the study of matter, energy and their interactions, and then chemistry, that is the study of composition of matter and its properties, and the last one is geology, that is the study of the planet Earth. The second branch of science is life sciences or biology. It is divided into botany and zoology. Botany is study of plants and zoology is study of animals. Now children, see what is scientific method. It is the systematic way to ask questions and find their answers through observations and experiments is known as the science or scientific method. For your investigation to be fair, you must follow different steps in a definite manner. The steps that are followed in the scientific method are: first one is identifying the problem, doing background research, developing a hypothesis, experimentation and verification, organizing data, drawing conclusion or putting a theory, application in technology. Scientists use the scientific method in their work. You too can be scientists. You can use this method to solve simple problems in your day-to-day life. Now children, see what is the physics. What do you know about physics? So physics is the branch of science that deals with the study of matter, energy and their interactions. We can also say that physics is the branch of science concerned with how matter and energy relate to and affect each other. As the entire universe is made up of matter and energy, physics is considered as the most fundamental of all the sciences. Now children, see the importance of physics. Physics has played an important role in our day-to-day life by building the foundation of modern technology. The study of physics is important because of the following reasons. Physics helps in expanding our knowledge of the fundamental laws that govern nature. The basic understanding of physics and physical laws are required in understanding other important subjects such as the earth, agriculture, and chemical, biological, and environmental sciences. The understanding of the fundamental laws of nature contributes to new technological developments, which in turn improve the quality of our life. Some of the major contributions of physics in various fields are transport, electricity, communications, space exploration. The development of different modes of transport such as cars, buses, ships, trains and aeroplanes have been possible because of our understanding of the laws of mechanics in physics. You can easily think of the large number of situations in which electricity plays an important role in our lives today. Fans, bulbs, televisions, refrigerators, computers, heaters, washing machines, air conditioners, and many other appliances are driven by electricity. Radio, television, computer, internet, and mobile phone have completely changed the way we live our lives. At the press of a few buttons, we are able to talk to people living in distant places and send them messages. Physics has played a great role in our understanding of the universe and the laws that govern it. With the invention of telescopes, we have been able to study the distant stars and other heavenly bodies. With the invention of rockets, we are now capable of launching different types of artificial satellites for navigation, weather forecast, communications, etc. Now children, see the harmful effects of science. In spite of the conveniences and comforts offered by science, scientific progress has also led to a number of problems such as pollution, climate change, and development of weapons of mass destruction. Science is neither good nor bad. It is in our hands to use it wisely to make the world a better place, or to use it foolishly to destroy what we have built up over centuries. The choice is ours.